Penguin Random House presents India Moving, A History of Migration by Chinmay Tumbe, read by Mathai Abraham. I am delighted to be writing this foreword for one of India's brightest and rising young economic scholars, Professor Chinmay Tumbe, of the Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad. India Moving is terrific in many ways. It is a kind of book that I would want to write and read and dip into and refer to from time to time. But those are not the only reasons for me writing this foreword. Nor are my motives sullied by obligation of reciprocity. Chinmay, who I got to know serendipitously, contributed wonderfully to a chapter in the Economic Survey of 2016-17. The reasons for my enthusiasm are different. There is a certain kind of scholarship that young Indian academics, especially in economics, have shied away from. A major reason is a suffocating straitjacket of the discipline as it is currently practiced in prestigious universities of the United States. Increasingly, the rewards are confined to and conferred upon those practicing a certain narrow conception of scholarship. This privileges the asking and answering of small questions, because only these can be answered through methods that the high priests of the academy certify as rigorously kosher. As a consequence, dismal science risks becoming small, lesser, wannabe science. Against this background, it takes a certain confidence, chutzpah even, to escape the choke of a throttling academy, especially for someone as professionally young as Chinmay Tumbe, and for someone who practices his vocation in India, far away from the academic centers of gravity. But make no mistake, India Moving, A History of Migration is a big book. Taking on nothing less than the history of national and international migration from, to, and within India over the last several centuries. Just the daring of and defiance implied in the attempted project deserves resounding praise and wide readership. But Chinmay does much more. He skillfully combines economics, history, vignette, anecdote, and the odd literary reference to lay out when, why, and how Indians have moved over the millennia. The book is backed up by years of serious scholarship, but avoids both narrowness and dreary denseness. It is animated by curiosity, wonder, and a sense of joyful exploration. Chinmay has clearly had fun writing India Moving, and it shows. The erudition is worn lightly, and Chinmay's wide reading leavens the exposition. One learns a lot from the book. How big is the Indian diaspora? What are the hotspots of emigration in India? How did Indians settle in the French territory of Réunion or find their way to the distant Pacific island of Fiji? What is the background behind Sikhs settling in Latin America? How did Indians first go to the Middle East? What were the associations between movements of particular communities and the building of economic capital? What are the two constants of the Indian diaspora? Spoiler answer, the use of water, not toilet paper, to perform ablutions, and the pressure cooker as the ubiquitously reliable kitchen aid. And more recently, how has migration changed within India, and how have remittances affected development within the country? The comprehensiveness of coverage is impressive. It seems that no internal displacement, no migration-related conflict, and no significant international migration over the last century has escaped the author's attention. A not insignificant contribution of the book might therefore be to serve as a treasure trove for others who wish to explore in greater detail one or more of the numerous instances of migration catalogued in the book. India Moving may well be the starting point and provocation for numerous PhDs. India Moving should be read, savored, and applauded. I hope it will encourage and embolden other Indian economists to emulate this example of undertaking rigorous but accessible and interesting scholarship. I cannot recommend this first effort from Professor Chinmay Tumbe highly enough. Arvind Subramanian, Chief Economic Advisor, Government of India. Author's note. Everyone has a migration story. I can vividly remember the day I had first landed in a new place for schooling, for higher studies, for work, and even for love. Divya, my wife, and I have now lived in 5 different cities across 3 continents. And when we look back at old photographs, we recollect how we pulled it off through beautiful landscapes, unending winters, strange furniture designs, and restrictive visa laws. Memory, nostalgia, and selective amnesia are powerful ingredients used to pepper personal and family migration narratives. These migration stories collectively form a system of internal and international migrations, of voluntary and involuntary migrations, and many other such typologies. This book is about one regional migration system, India, which has witnessed some of the largest voluntary and involuntary mass migrations in history. It is also the first book on the history of both internal and international migration, and voluntary and involuntary migration related to India. The book describes the origins of the incredible human diversity found within India and covers the migrations of artisans, merchants, slaves, students, warriors, workers, women, and many others. It reveals the persistence of labor migration since the late 19th century and provides a new perspective on the migration of business communities both within and outside India. It shows how 25 million people who traced their roots to India in the past 3 centuries were dispersed across the world, from Japan to Jamaica, and why internal diasporas matter as much as international diasporas. It documents the mass migrations caused by multiple partitions, refugee crises, and other displacements in Indian history, and their disproportionate impact on particular communities. And finally, it provides a perspective on migration and development in history and in 21st century India. In writing this book, I offer 4 core arguments. First, that migration or spatial mobility is not a recent phenomenon in India, in scale or variety, and that the country currently sustains the world's largest and longest voluntary migration episode in migration history, what I call the Great Indian Migration Wave. Second, the history of migration in India has often been closely bound with the idea of circulation. Third, migration and circulation have not influenced all subgroups evenly, and in particular, the lack of substantive spatial mobility continues to disempower the lowest-ranking castes of India. Finally, I argue that greater spatial mobility is a prerequisite for maintaining the pluralistic traditions of the country. Writing a book of this nature, wide in scope and reasonably concise, requires certain maxims and justifications for the regions and time periods chosen. In general, I cover those topics that have been well researched and have some body of evidence. This is important to state because virtually every Indian community has an origin myth that is fascinating to hear and is plausibly true, but extremely hard to verify. I also lay more emphasis on regions that appear to have a larger demographic weightage in Indian migration history. I use the old and new names of places interchangeably, usually denoting the names as they were used in the time period being discussed. The printing of maps on the Indian subcontinent has been constrained due to recently revised publication guidelines. This book is the culmination of an exciting decade-long academic and personal adventure that began with my doctoral research on migration history at the Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore, IIMB. A year at the Migration Policy Center of the European University Institute in Florence, Italy, and another year on a parental break spent in reading books at St. Louis, USA, helped me appreciate the contemporary and historical migration challenges faced in Europe, Africa, and the Americas. The experience of teaching urban studies at Tata Institute of Social Sciences, TISS, Hyderabad, and the Hitchhiker's Guide to Business and Economies across five centuries at IIM Ahmedabad opened new angles in migration history and the writings of Douglas Adams that I had not explored previously. As a member of a ministry-appointed working group on internal migration and research projects with bodies affiliated to the Ministry of Overseas Indian Affairs, I was privy to important contemporary debates on internal and international migration. Working with the offices of the Chief Economic Advisor led to innovations in methodologies in estimating migration stocks and flows. My research has therefore benefited from interactions with scholars across the world. Rupa Chanda, Arvind Subramanian, Irudaya Rajan, R. Bhagat, Carol Upadhyay, Vegard Iverson, Philippe Farg, Anna Trendefalidu, Jeffrey Jones, Yusuf Cassis, Jorge Flores, Meenakshi Thappan, Catherine Lum, Tirthankar Roy, Douglas Haynes, Bishnupriya Gupta, Dwijendra Tripathi, Nilanjana Ray, Azim Prakash, Amit Upadhyay, Hema Swaminathan, Errol D'Souza, Rakesh Basant, Anindya Chakraborty, Imran Khan, Valadishwaran C., Rajiv Khandelwal, Umi Daniel, Varsha Malwade, Kalyani Vartak, Priya Deshinkar, Divya Ravindranath, Deepak Malghan, Alak Sharma, S. Chandrasekhar, Partho Mukhopadhyay, and many more. Michael Danino and Himanshu Prabhar Ray were kind enough to point out the literature on migration in ancient India, which has attracted little scholarly attention till date outside the Aryan migration debate. I would like to thank the editors and reviewers of the Indian Economic and Social History Review, Business History Review, Migration and Development, Indian Journal of Labour Economics, India Migration Reports, Ideas for India, International Growth Centre Working Paper Series, and the Journal for Interdisciplinary Economics for providing an outlet for my research, some of which is reflected in this book. I would also like to thank the organizers of over 40 migration seminars and conferences that I participated in, and the staff at the following libraries and institutions: IIMA, IIMB, CDS Thiruvananthapuram, IIPS Mumbai, CSS Surat, ISID.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.